Hey guys, not too long ago, I bought this thing. The Republic Bricks. And there's a flaw with it already. I kid you not, that legit just happened. That was not like 1,000 takes to make sure it broke. But like legit, I just threw it up and it broke. That is one of the few flaws with this amazing wiring mall that's made by Republic Bricks Company, whatever you want to call it. I think it's made by Dave Customs or someone on Instagram, who knows. But this thing is one of the holy grails in my collection now, and I gotta tell you why, because this thing is absolutely amazing. I love this set so much. I wanted to buy it so bad long ago, but I saw the huge price of $320. Now, I cannot afford $320 for a set like this. I just do not see the value there that much. But this thing was so beautiful. I'm just like, oh, I wish I could get that. So I'm just going to go buy the one stud one, which is okay. It's not as good as this one because these engines are like from the UCS wiring or something. Like, they are huge. And this thing is absolutely awesome. Like, look at these back engines. Like, this set is great. I kid you not. But then the heavens looked up upon. Dude, that lightning was not, like, that's not anything. Like, that was just happening outside. That was not a sound. That was lightning outside. That was kind of creepy, not gonna lie. But the heavens opened up, as I was saying, and Tabloid Bricks sold this for $80 to me with only a few parts missing, such as like these back pieces, like right here, and like one of these back beams missing. Like, there really wasn't a lot of pieces missing. So I had to get those parts eventually, but this set for $80, totally worth it. I'm so glad I got this thing. So let's get into this video on my thoughts on this model. Even though I don't really support Republic Bricks opinions, some of them I do, some of them I don't, but he's a very controversial guy. But we're just talking about how great of a model this Y-Wing is and whether or not you guys should get it too. First off, just to say that this set is an absolute beauty. Like, look at this thing. This thing is so beautiful. I love the Fall First Y-Wing from the Clone Wars. The animators did a great job of like designing it. Like, the new color scheme, the white and the blue match very good together. But there are some flaws with this model, such as sagging and a lot of things that aren't great, even for a display standpoint, because this is what mainly this set is for, display, not for, you know, play. Now, there's one main big problem for this set, which drives me nuts every single time I pick it up. And then there are a few smaller things for this set. The main thing that really is annoying, though, is these massive engines sagging. Now, I love the fact that they use massive engines from the UCS model of the Y-Wing, but they sag like crazy because there's only this amount of support. This right here is the only support holding this heavy booster engine, which they did use on the UCS Y-Wing. Now, they didn't use the exact kind, as you guys know, but like, this is pretty heavy on the inside. I can actually take one of these off for you because there is a lot of like inside like strength stuff. Like, you see these big columns, like those weigh a lot. Like, there's a lot of heavier bricks inside this set, but as you can see, they use less support here than they do for a Lego Y-Wing model. But again, this is meant for play, but that one right there is meant for display. But still, if I'm displaying this model, I want to see the engines to it not so saggy, and it's just really annoying. Like, you can see even the bottom right here is sagging like crazy. Now, there is a good reason to explain this. The problem comes from these landing things. Oh my goodness, like, the landing gear causes all of these problems. And without them, let's just say this model may work well better. As you can see, like right here, like there's a big gap. Like, if you just use one brick for support, it would work perfectly. But if you put one brick there, then you can't really close this all the way. It'll be like open like that bit. I tried it and I actually do it like this so that I can actually use my Y-Wing for play features and stop motions in the near future. But that is the major flaw of this model, and it drives me nuts. Before we get into why I think this set is so good, there are a few other tiny flaws that aren't too bad to deal with on this model on a daily basis. So over here, there is this little small thing right here. This piece continuously falls off, and it happens on the other side as well. That's because there's only one piece connected to it, which is super annoying. And when you hold it, it continuously falls off, and it's very hard to put back on once it does fall off, so that, you know, it doesn't fall off again. And you see, there we go. It keeps, and yeah, that's pretty annoying. And then again, over here on the back side, this thing fell off a ton. I actually already lost the other assembly for it that used to be on the other side because it just fell off so much. And there usually are bricks right here It's just since I bought this from Tabloid Bricks, a great guy, for $80 with a few parts missing. That's why I don't have those bricks replaced yet. They have UCS engines on the Y-Wing, a regular play scale Y-Wing. They got massive, the same size as the UCS Y-Wing engines on it, and that is so cool. It makes it so menacing, and when I first got this set, I'm like, whoa, these engines are massive. The size of the thing is so huge. It really feels like a heavy-duty thing, and when you hold it in your hand, you're just in love with this model right from the start. And the engines, oh my goodness, these engines are so good. Dude, I can't even. Again, engine setting, big problem, and that's why you have pieces on them to support them, but again, right now it's not being shown. But anyways, look at these engines. They're so cool. Like, just take a look for a quick second. This engine has so much detail. You take this off, you got a purple little light there with this T-square kind of thing. I don't know what you call it, but like, that looks phenomenal. I don't think I could have designed that any better than the way this set has it. Like, it's just so cool to see that feature on the wiring. Like, it's beautiful. Honestly, it's quite beautiful. Then the next amazing feature on this, I mean, this opens up. It's no big whoop, but it still opens up. That's a pretty nice feature. And then, dude, I love this cockpit thing. Now, I may just be a little, like, overhyped about this because I don't actually have a 2007 Clone Wars model Y-Wing, and that's been my dream set for a long time to get that. But, like, this thing's pretty cool as well. It is a little difficult to get a figure inside the Y-Wing right here, as you guys can see. And I don't even think one fits in there. So you guys have to just like do and maybe put a minifigure head in there or like a torso and a head that might fit. But a minifigure really doesn't fit in here unless you have the minifig's head sticking through his tiny hole, which is honestly kind of hard to do, not gonna lie. I did that with the Ghost from 2014 with Zeb, and it was a difficult thing to do every single time. If you look at these two models together, the thing that stands out the most is the engines, and those engines just really sell the model for me. Like, even though they're sagging, this model just looks so good, and I'm absolutely in love with the armor of it and the Clone Wars and how heavy duty it is. And if you have a Clone Wars Fallen First Pilot, which I do have, this set is just even better than it already is. So in the end of this set for $320 is not worth it. I would try going to Dave Customs or somewhere like that, trying to get the parts and not buy it from Republic Bricks, because this thing, I can. This is not $320 right here. This is like $120, $150 at most, I feel like. But again, the part pieces, like everything, like it takes time to sort, but like, and it's bricklink, like it's not coming from the Lego company, so I get that standpoint on why it's so expensive, but $320, don't spend $320 on this. That is way too much. But let me know what you guys think about this Y-Wing down below in the comments. What do you think about Republic Bricks? And I will be doing a video in the future whether or not he is a scam or not. I don't know when that's going to come out. I've been wanting to do it forever. But from what I've seen, I got a free minifigure from him once because I shared his auction on my story. And it shipped and it came. He paid like $10 for total. Like for $6 shipping for a $4 figure. I mean, that seems pretty legit to me. But I've heard tons of people get scammed by him. So, is he a scam? Is he not? I really had to do more research into it. But from my standpoint right now, he's not a scam. So I'll see you all in the next one. Make sure to leave a like and subscribe down below. Bye.